Namaskar, I am Dr. Aman Puri, Consul General of India to Dubai and the Northern Emirates of Sharjah, Ajman, Ras Al Khaimah, Fujairah and Umm Al Quwain. I would like to extend my very warm greetings on the new year, wishing you, your family members and all your friends very good health, joy and happiness during the coming year. The year 2020 has been quite a challenging one, an unprecedented crisis which all of us had to deal with. But I must say that UAE and India have both shown their resilience in handling this pandemic. The large Indian community in the UAE has been helping not only their Indian brothers and sisters during this unprecedented times, but also their brothers and sisters from over 200 nationalities who call UAE their second home. I am extremely grateful to the entire team of NTV and especially the chairman of NTV, Mr. Mattukuddi, who has been very kind and gracious to enable this interaction with all of you. It is a real pleasure to meet all of you. It's our first interaction, but hopefully now we'll have a very regular interaction. During this time of the unprecedented crisis, our Indian community members have been standing shoulder to shoulder with the UAE authorities in handling this pandemic, and today the world is recognizing that UAE is a shining example in handling the COVID pandemic, whether it is in the field of robust testing regime, whether it is in terms of handling people with their queries and advising them on the protocols, or the rollout of the vaccines. UAE has really been a world leader, and we are very certain that with the resilience of the people here and with the support and vision of the UAE leadership, we will be getting through and emerging stronger. I would like to take this opportunity to extend my gratitude to all the frontline workers who have been working so hard in protecting all of us during this COVID crisis. They have been putting their own lives at risk, and we must fully acknowledge their contribution in keeping everyone here healthy and safe. I am aware that a large number of the Indian workers were laid off during this time, which is understandable because there were huge economic pressures and stress on the different sectors of the economy. But we are also equally certain that economic revival will happen sooner rather than later, and we will see the Indian workers returning. We are already seeing green shoots and the signs of revival, but I'm sure in the near future we will see them in greater measure. And I would appeal to all Indian entrepreneurs and employers to support their staff, their employees during this time, because it is your workers who have helped you build these empires and who will help you sustain during the coming years. I would also like to suggest that let us not waste this crisis and let us convert it into an opportunity. Let us realize the importance of financial literacy for all the workers and for everyone who is living and working here coming from India. So I would appeal to everyone to make sure that all of you, including your workforce, has a bank account, has means of saving, whether it is through the National Pension Scheme of one of the public sector banks of India or from any other institution. The important thing is the concept of saving for your own financial security. During your productive years, you give your best time to the UAE and you've made a huge contribution here. It is also very important for yourself to ensure that your financial security in the years to come is safeguarded. I must say that the Government of India and the people of India are extremely appreciative and grateful for all the work you've been doing here, for the support you provide to the Indian economy, whether it is in the form of remittances, almost 20 billion from the UAE to India on an annual basis, whether it is form of significant investment coming from the UAE into India, or for the huge amount of imports which you are supporting from India into the UAE. There are several priority areas like food security, health security, AI and artificial intelligence, IT, and others, where the UAE and India can do much more together. Soon, we would be working on upskilling, retraining, and attempts to re-employ people who have lost their jobs, and we would seek your support on that too. Just today morning, we had the extreme pleasure of spending time with our Indian workers at one of the workers' accommodation. It was a huge opportunity for us to spend time with them and share about their life experiences living here in the UAE. We all ate together, sang and danced together. We also tried to see in what ways the consulate can better serve them. What is important is that we deeply value the contribution our workers' community is making, not only to the economy of UAE, but also to India, by sending huge remittances, which not only support their own families, but also the economy of India. For the month of January 21, we already have some very important events lined up, which are annual events: the Pravasi Bharati Devas on the 9th of January, then the Vishwa Hindi Devas on the 10th of January, and of course, the Republic Day of India on the 26th of January. I would urge all of you to join us virtually, because you would appreciate and understand that due to the COVID restrictions, we may not be able to celebrate it in the way we've been celebrating every year. But I'm very sure that soon, and hopefully next year, we'll be able to come back to our physical celebrations. This is also a time which has taught us the value and importance of the virtual meetings, which enables us to connect with people from all over the world. So we will continue to use the virtual means more and more in reaching out to all of you, and you must connect with us virtually so that we can remain in touch. I would urge all of you to follow all COVID guidelines and restrictions which are announced by the local government and the local authorities, which will help you to remain safe and help you to keep your family and your friends safe. It is our responsibility to follow all these guidelines, because as the governments are doing their best to address the problem of the COVID, all stakeholders and each one of us are responsible to take care of our own health, and we must do our best to support the authorities in their endeavors. With these words, I would like to once again thank the entire management of NTV for giving me this opportunity, and we look forward to your questions in the future. As you know, we are available through various means. We have a toll-free number, which is 800 India. So it's 800-46342. And I would suggest if all of you who are listening to this program could kindly save it as one of the numbers which you could call 24/7, 365 days, whenever there is any need for you to seek out a support from the consulate. I would also urge you to use this medium to share your grievances or your comments or feedback to the consulate through the NTV channels. You can also send your emails to cgspeaking@ntvuae.ae and through the WhatsApp number 058-26-77-771. I would like to thank the NTV for creating this medium for us to better understand the feedback from the community, and please make full use of it. Thank you so much.
ജനങ്ങൾക്കൊപ്പം വാർത്തയ്ക്കൊപ്പം നന്മയോടൊപ്പം NTV UAE to the world.